This tutorial requires a valid iTunes account. Open a web browser and in the address bar type in ipsw.me or click the link in the description. On the IPSW page, scroll down and look for iTunes and download the latest version for your operating system. During the iTunes setup, untick Use iTunes as your default media player. When iTunes is installed, do not launch it, just click Finish. It is only required to recognize the file you'll be downloading later. Once that is done, open your browser and in the address bar type in www.cydiaimpactor.com or click the link in the description. On the Cydia page, download the Windows version and choose Save. When it is downloaded, choose Open Folder. In your Downloads folder, drag the Impactor zip file onto your desktop folder. Then go to your desktop, right click on the Impactor zip folder and extract to your desktop. Untick Show Extracted Files. Then go back to your browser and in the address bar type in www.iphonecake.com or click the link in the description. In the search bar at the top right, type in Kodi and hit enter. Click on the Kodi icon, not the legacy one. And on the Kodi page, scroll down and click on the blue link that says www.filepub.net link. Click allow once if the status bar appears. You may need to click the link twice. If a pop-up box does appear, just close it down. Then click download file. Then choose download as a free user. Save the file to your downloads folder. It may take a little while to download. Once it is downloaded, open up your downloads folder and drag the Kodi iOS file to your desktop. You can then close all the windows and plug in your iPad to your computer. If iTunes opens up, close it down and ignore any error messages about syncing the device. Then on your desktop, double click the Impactor folder you unzipped earlier. Find the Impactor .exe file that looks like a drill and double click it. Choose Run when the security warning appears. Then drag the Kodi iOS file you downloaded over the top part of the Impactor box. It will then ask you for your iTunes username and password. You will need to use a genuine iTunes account for this. Click OK on the Apple Developer Warning and wait while it extracts and installs Kodi on your iPad. It will take a few minutes. When it's finished, the Kodi icon will appear on your iPad. You can now unplug your iPad from your computer. Then before opening Kodi on your iPad, click on Settings and in General, scroll down to the Device Management and you will see your iTunes account listed. Click on the Device Management, then click on the Developer app with the name of your iTunes account. Then click on Trust, and Trust again when the dialog box appears. You can now open Kodi. It looks a little different on the iPad, so to make it look familiar, click on the Settings button at the bottom right. It's in the middle and looks like a cog. In the Settings, click on the Appearance tab and then Skins and change to Confluence. Say yes to the changes, then click on the Home icon on the bottom right. Kodi is now installed on your iPad and you are ready to add the plugins you need. I will make another video on how to install plugins for your iPad.